non-metals, right? Already it is studied that how the chemical properties of metals and non-metals are going on, right? The chemical properties of metals and non-metals are nothing but the when the metals and the non-metals are react with an oxygen, water, acids and also the bases, right? When in the case of the oxygen, when the metals are react with an oxygen means metal oxide is formed. In the case of the water, when the metals are react with the water means the metal dioxide is formed. So likewise, these are the methods when the metals are react with the oxygen, water, right? But today we shall move on how the metals and the non-metals are react with an acids and bases. Okay, for the reaction with acids. Yes, sir. Generally, the metals are react with the acids, but in case of the non-metal does not react with an acids. Usually, the metals are react with an acid. The metals are react with an acids means it is one of the producing a sound that we call it as pop sound. What? Pop sound. Then what do you mean by the pop sound? The letters see in as reactions. Reaction with bases. Okay, what will be indicates? What will be then? How the pop sound will be appear? Right? Okay. When any one of the metal are react with an acid means some of that produced in a sound that we call it as a pop. The pop sound. Where how it is identified? The pop sound when it is metals are react with some of the other chemicals that will be producing some of the gas that we call it as a pop sound. Okay. Yes. The metals are react with an acid, but the non-metals are does not react with an acid. Okay. The copper. Usually the copper does not react with an dilute hydrochloric acid, even on heating also. But in case of the sulfuric acid, it easily reacts, and also it easily reacts and rapidly for continuously process. Okay. Thus, the metals are react with an acid, but the non-metals does not react with an acid. Okay. The copper does not react with an dilute hydrochloric acid, but even on heating also, but in case of the it react with sulfuric acid. This is about the how the reactions of metals, how the reactions of acids will be going on. That when the metals are suspended to the acids, what will be happen? Okay. Continue next. The reaction with bases. The next, the bases. It is one of the experiment is there. Just you preparation of the sodium hydroxide in a test tube. Take a clean test tube and prepare the solution. Okay, prepare the solution of sodium hydroxide. And that test tube, you add the 5 ml of water. When it is suspended to the sodium hydroxide and water, you just drop of the aluminium foil into a test tube. Okay, after the adding of the 5 ml of water, you just add the drop of the aluminium foil into a test tube. After, you don't disturb the test tube. After that one, bring a burning matchstick near the mouth of the test tube. I'm sure you, yes, this is one of the test tube. There, and sodium hydroxide and water will be suspended here. Okay, and in drop of the aluminium foil enters into a test tube. Then and bring a burning of the matchstick into a near the mouth of the test tube. When the burning of the matchstick is react with the sodium hydroxide means one of the gas is produced. One of the gas, it is in a colorless. Okay, it is in a colorless. That we call it as pop sound. One of the pop sound is produced as a gas means hydrogen gas. Okay, this indicates that when the sodium hydroxide is dissolved, is reacts with an water and aluminium foil, the pop sound is reduces, or pop sound is produces the hydrogen gases on the reaction with bases. But in case the metals are reacts with an sodium hydroxide to produce an hydrogen gases. The metal is nothing but aluminium foil. When the aluminium foil is reacts with the sodium hydroxide, means the hydrogen gas is produced. Okay, the reactions of non-metals with the bases are complex in nature. Yes, all the non-metals are react. All the some of the non-metals are react with the bases, but it is in a complex in nature. Right? This is the reaction with acids and bases. Okay. We already know how the metals and the non-metals are react with the acids and also the bases, right? In the bases, the reaction with the bases in the case of the metals and the non-metals, some of the reactions are formed, that we call it as a displacement reactions. Displacement means any one of the metal, they can be replaced with the another one metal. For example, if the zinc metal can be able to respond, able to replace the another one metal, the copper, sulfur, so likewise, these are the displacement or replacementing of the metals, that we call it as a displacement reactions. Okay, just you observe the picture, 100 ml beakers of beakers and label them A, B, C, D and E, and 50 ml of water in each of the beaker. Then dissolve in each beaker a spoon of each substances. Substances means are likewise in a chemicals or metals. In the having a different in manner for each of the 5 beakers. Okay, what will be react and don't disturb for these beakers. Keep the beakers without any disturbing. Okay. Then after some time, when it is react will stops, you just observe and note down the from the beaker A FeSO4, the remaining one of the same content will copper. Okay, when the CuSO4 is react with an Fe means FeSO4 and copper is present. Copper sulfate is react with an iron. What will be formed? Iron sulfate is formed. Thus, the copper is remains at the bottom of the beaker B. Okay. The next one. What will we have? What will be changes in the beaker C, beaker D, and also the beaker E? In the beaker C, the zinc is replaces the copper, and beaker D, the iron is replaces the copper, and the beaker E is zinc is replaces the iron. So how it? But in case of the D and E, but in case of the D, beaker D and beaker E, there is no changes. There is no change will be occurred. There is no changes. There is no replacement of the one metal to the another one metal, because the zinc having a more reactive than the copper and iron. So the iron, this is metal, they are having a more reactive. It contains in a strong basic in nature. That's why the zinc is more reactive than the copper and iron. There is no change in the beaker C and beaker D and E. The science has it is one of the practical in the nature, right? The chemistry is nothing but practical. So the science is not an it is not an assuming. It is one of the practical in the nature. So it has to maintain some of the rules. What are the rules? They are containing means the zinc is more reactive than the copper and also the iron, and the more reactive metal replace the less reactive metal. Just to observe the picture, more reactive metal is replaces with nothing but the zinc is more reactive, right? It is replaces the copper and iron. So the likewise, the more reactive metal is replaces the less reactive metal, but the less reactive metals cannot replace the more reactive metal. Okay, very important of the displacement of the reactions, how it will be changed from the 5 beakers. That's why the displacement of the reactions is nothing but it is when the metals can react with another one metal, they are able to displace, they are able to replace from one metal to the another one metal. Okay, for next class we shall discuss what are the uses of the metals and also the non-metals.